And the third one is tetrasporic embryo sac. This tetrasporic embryo sac development, the embryo sac, both the meiotic divisions, karyokinesis not followed by cytokinesis. That means here the meiosis 1-2, there is no formation of cell plate. So all the four megaspores, they develop, they participate in the formation of the embryo sac, and there is no degeneration of any of the megaspores. So this is a Cenos megaspore, because there is no, as the karyokinesis will not followed by cytokinesis, there is no cell plate formation. The four haploid nuclei at the end of the meiosis are enclosed in a common cytoplasm, and it form a cenomegaspore. This four megaspore, cenomegaspore, it undergoes mitosis, and it will develop into 8, and it will, in the second mitosis, it develops into 16, or it will differ. Now, based on this difference of development patterns, or the mitotic and mitotic patterns, the development of these nuclei or the embryo sac in tetrasporic embryo sac development, it is of different types based on the arrangement of nuclei. First one is called as Adoxa type, second one is Drusa type, third one is Plumbago type, fourth one is Plumbagella type, fifth one is Fritillaria type, sixth is Pinea type, and the last one is Peperomia type. All these differences are based on the arrangement of the nuclei. Let us see these different types of tetrasporic embryos sac. The first one is Adoxa type. Adoxa type, it was formerly known as Lilium type. It is characterized by all four megaspore nuclei undergoing just one more division to form an 8 nucleate embryo. See, in megasporogenesis, as I said, after meiosis, four nuclei are formed, and this is cenomegaspore, because there is no plate formation, all the four nuclei are participated in it. And if you look at here, only one mitotic division occurred, and mitosis 2 and mitosis 3 is absent. So only one mitotic division occurs, and it results in 8 nucleate condition. The 8 nucleate condition here, after this 8, the two cells, that means these 8 nuclei, they arrange for each, like four nuclei are arranged at the colossal end, and four nuclei arranged at the micropylar end. The three micropylar end nuclei, they develop into one into egg, two into synergids, and the three at the colossal end, they develop into antipodal cells. And the central two nuclei, and that means one from here and the other from here, they will come and arrange at the center, and a cell wall is developed around them, and it is called a central cell. So in Adoxa, the tetrasporic type, it results in 8 nuclei, 7 cell structure. This Adoxa type of embryo sac development is usually seen in Adoxa and Caprifoliaceae family members like Adoxa and Sambucus. Next is Drusa type. In Drusa type, here, look at here, the meiosis, the megaspore, in megasporogenesis, the cenomegaspore is formed, and out of the four, three move to the micropyle colossal end, and one nucleus move to the micropylar end, and it undergoes two divisions, mitotic divisions, and results in 16 nucleate conditions. So four gives rise to 8 in first mitosis, and in second mitosis it gives rise to 16 nuclei. So out of how many are present here? 16 nucleated and 15 cell structure embryo sac is present in Drusa tetrasporic development. Here, out of these four, one will come here at the center, and out of the 12, one will goes at the center, and the two form the they will cell wall formation occurs, and they form a central cell. And here the three will develop into the micropylar, and the three develop into one into egg and the two into synergids. Here the remaining level will act as the antipodal cells. So this is 16 nucleate and 15 cell structure present in Drusa oppositive folia of APAC members. The next type is plumbago type. The third type is plumbago type. Here, if you look at here, the tetrad in megasporogenesis, the tetrad, that is the cenomegaspore, out of the four nuclei, the each nuclei, they move to each side. So one to micropylar side, one to colossal side, and two to on either side. So this will undergoes two mitotic divisions resulting in 16 nuclei. And third mitosis division is, mitotic division is totally absent. Here, the mature embryo looks like this. So these are the out of the four, one will come here, and one will come here, and one here, and one here. So in the central cell, it will form four nuclei. It consists of four nuclei. Till here, the central cell consists of only two nuclei, the polar nuclei. Here, the polar nuclei are four in number. That means if in the endosperm, that will become four plus one nucleus from pollen grains. The endosperm is 5N in nature. So this is the importance in pinea type. So the micropylar end, they will become the cell, the nuclei, they develop into three cells, two synergids and one egg cell. And the other here, the 3, 3, 3, 9, they will become, they will act as antipodals. And the four nuclei will be at the central cell. So this is 16 nucleate but 13 celled structure in pinea type. Next, fifth one is peperomia type. Peperomia type is also very interesting type of development. Here, like pinea type, here also the four nuclei, they move to each end, and they after first mitosis, they develop into 8 nuclei. After that, in mitosis 2, it will gives rise to 16 nucleate, but all of these are dispersed in the megaspore, that is dispersed in the cell. And 8 become polar nuclei and 6 become antipodal. This is 8 become polar nuclei, 6 become antipodals. This 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 become antipodal cells, and 8 of them, they become polar nuclei, and they form a central cell here. And at the at the micropylar end, one egg and one synergid remain at the micropylar end. So in peperomia type, 16 nucleate and 9 celled condition. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 antipodals, 2, 1 egg and 1 synergy, and 8 polar nuclei. If after fertilization, this 8 polar nuclei along with the 1 nucleus from pollen grain, it forms endosperm, and the endosperm nature will be 9N in nature. Okay, and this type of embryo sac development is seen in Piperaceae family, Peperomia of Piperaceae family. The next one, the sixth one, is Fritillaria type of embryo sac development. Here, the tetrad, in the previous ones, the four nuclei move to four different edges, right? But here, three will move to the collosal end and one will move to micropylar end. These three will fuse to form a three and triploid nuclei. This is an interesting fact. This is an interesting phenomena. The three nuclei in the tetrad will fuse to form a three N nuclei. That is a triploid. This is a spindle fusion, and this will undergo mitosis. And at the micropylar end, two nuclei are formed. At the collosal end, another two triploid nuclei will be formed. It undergoes second mitotic division and forms 8 nuclei. But these 8 nuclei, out of these 8 nuclei, 4 are N in nature and the other 4 are 3N in nature, triploid in nature. And the mitosis 3 is absent, and the mature embryo sac in Fritillaria type possess 8 nucleate, 7 celled structure. The polar nuclei consists of 1 N nuclei from this side and 1 triploid nuclei from the collosal end. So it is 4N in nature. This is 3N and then 1N. And if it, after fertilization, the endosperm will become 5N in nature. Moving on to the last type of development or tetrasporic development of embryo sac type is Plumbagella type. This is also more or less like Fritillaria type, but here mitosis 2 and meiosis, mitosis 3 is totally absent. If you look at the previous picture in Fritillaria type, spindle fusion occurs and the triploid is formed, but it undergoes mitosis 1 and mitosis 2 and resultant in formation of 8 nucleated 7 cell structure. Whereas here, here only one mitotic division occurs and it results in the 8 nucleate 3 cell structure. Out of this 8 nucleate, one triploid nuclei is present at the collosal end. One haploid nuclei develops into egg. And at the central cell, the polar nuclei will be one haploid nuclei from the micropylar end and one from the triploid nuclei from the collosal end moves at the center and forms into a central cell. That consists, and when it after fertilization, it gives rise to 5N because it is 1 plus 3 plus 1 nuclei from pollen grain, the micro gametophyte, and it will gives rise to 5N endosperm. So, this is about the different types of embryo sac development. Now, we'll see the nuclei status and the ploidy in the endosperm of each of these tetrasporic types of embryo sacs. In Edoxa type, number of nuclei will be 2, but the ploidy, the endosperm after fertilization, it will consist of 3 and in nature. In chrysanthemum type, it is 3 nuclei, and after the endosperm will become 4 and in nature. Plumbago type, there are in the polar nuclei, it consists of 4. In plumbago, plumbagella, and fritillaria and pinea type, the polar nuclei consists of these 4 nuclei, and the endosperm, resultant endosperm, is 5 and in nature. And the last one, in the peperomia type, the nuclei are 8 in the polar central cell, and the resultant endosperm is 9 and in nature. So this is the development of female gametophyte and types of embryo sac developments.